There is this terrible campaign by some people that against the Saitam Medical College. They have various arguments. Some arguments are ridiculous. We have started a campaign. People who are interested in democracy, in order to defend the democratic rights of the students and also the investor of the private medical college. Now in this country, there is a free education designed to give free education to everybody, starting from kindergarten up to university level. Now that is there and it's expanding. We have campaigned that 6% of the government income should be directed towards education, and all that has been done. At the same time, there is free freedom for private sector to intervene in education. This has been there for a long time. It is not a thing that have come in recent period. Even the time of takeover of the private schools, some private schools were left out of takeover. St. Thomas's College, Trinity College, Buddhist Ladies College, and so on and so forth. Yeah, they resisted and they said we want to continue private education in certain sections. So they were allowed to function, and it has expanded. Now today, the private sector is given the freedom to give education at all levels, side by side the free education. That is the situation today under this capitalist setup. But we who are opposed to capitalism, and we are fighting for some socialist setup, but in the moment we have to defend the democratic rights within capitalism. Now if there is freedom for education, if there is freedom for establishing institutes to create engineers, accountants, managers and various other professions, why should that freedom not be given to medical section? In medicine also, there is a market for education. Therefore, investors are interested. They were not interested so far in long period because the cost of providing medical education is very high. So, they did not come forward. But now, in the present time, after the improvement of technologies, they have found that it is a sector where they could invest, and they have invested in the medical college. So there is no argument. If you can have engineering education privately, accountancy and other subjects, so much of professions, so many professions, then why is it not allowed for the medical profession? It is allowed, and if legally you can invest in medical education, and somebody has started this medical college. Now the problem is, the real problem is whether the medical college is up to the standard. Now what is the body of, who are the people who are responsible for that? It is the profession itself. Only in each profession, the elite of the profession, those who are the top of the practice, are responsible for keeping the level and the standard of the particular profession. Now, in each profession, they have a committee, some kind of council, engineering council, accountants council, and medical council, and so on. Here in Sri Lanka, there is a medical council, which has taken the responsibility of identifying who the real practitioner, any violation of the practice will be looked after or by the medical council, and they are responsible for the future doctors as well. Now, medical council, on their investigation, they have said this Seattle Medical College not up to standard with the present setup. So they have advised certain changes and improvements. So it is the responsibility of the investor, the capitalist, to spend more money and make the institute up to the standard and pass the standard sit test and get the registration of medical council. Now we have to press for that. That is what one aspect of our campaign. We say the investor should be responsible that the college is up to the standard given by the medical council. On the other hand, medical council has the responsibility to keep a watch and also to help them to improve the setup, and this, they can say which area and how you could improve that. That also is the responsibility of the medical council. Today, the president of the medical council is Fonseca.
Carlo
Fonseca, our friend and past, we were together in the Samasamaj party. So being a Samasamajist, he should know what to do. He must be responsible for the students who have come into this school thinking that they are going to get a medical degree. And they have got the minimum standard. They have got passes in the A-level. And then it is the duty of Carlo Fonseca, Professor Carlo Fonseca, who has been distributing rationalism in this country, making people more rational, then be rational in this issue and come out with a solution for the students and the people who have invested, and see that equality prevails. There cannot be difference between medical profession and engineering profession or any other profession. All professions are equally important, and they should be guided by their own professional merit and so on. And they, therefore, they should find means and ways to improve the medical college up to standard. Some people are talking about socialism. There is no issue of socialism here. This is a private market and private investment. But why we are fighting? Because as Samasamajis, equality should prevail. Just as much equality should prevail between nationalities. There again, it is a bourgeois democratic problem, not a socialist problem. We stood by equality, autonomy, and national freedom to decide one's future, right of self-determination, because it is a democratic problem, and the democratic way out is that. Similarly here, even though this is a bourgeois investment and capitalist education, we are responsible to defend equal rights and equal opportunity within capitalism, and see that democracy prevails. Thank you.